check it out.
I'm delighted to welcome you all to Birmingham and Solihull Mental Health Foundation Trust Values Awards 2023. Yes, it's really good to be here. I'd firstly like to thank our BSL interpreters, which is Alicia Morsley and also Dave Appleby, who are here with us tonight. It is wonderful that this year we can celebrate in person at this beautiful venue. And tonight is a celebration of all of the great work that is happening each and every day at Team BSMHFT. Unfortunately, tonight we can only see the highlights because of the time constraints we have this evening. You'll see just the highlights of that work tonight and those that have been chosen as winners of awards. But this is actually really just a microscopic cross-section of many, many examples of wonderful work by teams and individuals across Team BSMHFT. The nominations were judged by my fellow board members, executives and non-executives, with governors and also our expert by experience and staff side chair as well, their valuable input actually in the judging process. Every single person has expressed how difficult it was to choose only three nominees to receive gold, silver, bronze winners from each of the nine categories. And you will see in some instances that we actually couldn't make a decision. You'll see what I mean later. I'll hand over to Rasheed.
Thank you, Phil. Thank you. Listen, how great is it to be here? It's just fabulous, isn't it, to be? And like Phil, like all of you, I'm just really delighted that we were able to be here tonight and to do this. It's fabulous to be able to see so many smiling faces, some nerves, some anticipation. And, you know, this is an opportunity for us all to be together across Birmingham and Solihull Mental Health Foundation Trust team, Team BSMHFT. And it's a real chance to meet those that we wouldn't normally have a chance to meet. And I hope that you've made connection with people that maybe you haven't seen for a long time because you're working in your own team. To build bonds, new friendships, and to really understand a lot about different contributions and roles in the organisation to the fantastic work that we do here in the Trust every single day. We all know how very difficult it has been over the last few years, and that those challenges haven't gone away. So to read with such compassion, the inclusiveness, the commitment, that despite all of those challenges that you have thrown at us, that have been thrown at us, that it makes us all the more inspiring to have read all of those nominations. And as Phil said, it's been really tough for everybody to determine who should get the honours tonight. I know I speak for every board member, every governor, every colleague and partner that's working here with us today, that we sincerely believe that everyone that was nominated already is a winner in our eyes. So all of you are winners already. That your contribution, the way you go about your daily work, the way you support each other, the way you support our service users, meant enough to someone who'd seen you, knows you, to take the time to nominate you means that you are both valued and that you are living our values every day in your contribution to caring for our service users and supporting our colleagues in a compassionate, inclusive and committed manner. My thanks and congratulations are due to everyone who nominated and to those who took the time to make the nominations. Thank you to those in particular. And just a reminder for everybody, if you haven't already bought your raffle tickets, do so now because we'll be closing the raffle at the break around the awards. To start the celebrations, I'll now hand over to Patrick, our Deputy Chief Executive and our Executive Director of Strategy, People and Partnerships, and Jazz, our Associate Director of Equality, Diversity and Inclusion and Organisational Development, for the first of tonight's awards.
Thank you, Roisin and Phil. I'm pleased that we're able to be part of recognising Team BSMHFT and achievements tonight. Jazz and I are here to present the Compassionate Award for an individual or individuals who continuously demonstrate our trust value of compassionate in everything that they do at work, always listening and considering others. My thanks to Steph Bloxham, one of our governors, who also helped us in our judging of this. So the shortlisted nominees are
this is when the video plays.
So I joined the Trust in 2020 as a bank HCA, worked with the home treatment team over at Xenia Centre, Spark Hill, and recently moved to the Headington and King Standing home treatment team. I think being compassionate is very, very key and essential as a community nurse. It helps you to have a good understanding of what's going on for patients, when you actively communicate to them and listen to their concerns, and also empathizing in terms of understanding where they are with their mental health and the journey ahead of them in terms of their recovery. So I think it's important for us as practitioners to not underestimate or overlook the physical needs of patients. Hence the reason why I suggested that as a team, we need to engage people in physical assessment, which involves understanding if they have any physical health needs. And in the recent time, I volunteered to undergo a training within the home treatment for ECG, because it's important for us to know the status of patient before we introduce some certain medication, which are antipsychotics. I felt ecstatic when I received the email about my nomination as one of the people shortlisted for being compassionate in the Trust. I think it's a very big honor for me and a massive privilege to be found to be worthy of the nomination as being compassionate.
So my role as a clinical lead is I work within GP surgeries in primary care as a clinician offering assessment and support for people who go to their GP who need support with their mental health. So we get referrals from a GP and sometimes CMHTs who've been referred to their GP as well. And we offer triage initially, see if there's anything we can do to support at that stage. So we try to support people at the first stages of their mental health journey and avoid them having to go to any secondary services if necessary. I think I show my compassion through just always being, you know, person-centred, I'd like to think that the service users I work with would think I was compassionate just through being caring and trying to go as above and beyond as we can for those people. I think that's probably most how I could explain my compassion without blowing my own trumpet. I would say I'm most proud of rolling out a new service which has offered, you know, a really good pathway into mental health services, and I'm really proud of, you know, being able to support people at that primary care level and intervene at the early stages of their mental health concerns and make a real difference. Nomination means a lot, actually. I genuinely didn't think I'd get nominated, and I think probably everyone who's nominated would say the same, but it means an awful lot to be acknowledged for what you do, and it feels, I feel something I'm really proud of, and I really genuinely appreciate having, you know, my skills acknowledged and being appreciated, yeah. So to the person that nominated me, thank you so much, and you know who you are, and I really appreciate your ongoing support, and I really couldn't have done it without you, so thank you so much.
Andrea is a senior occupational therapist at David Bromley House. With a deeply caring nature, Andrea does everything she can to support residents to have a better journey with us. One resident was showing signs of depression, having difficulty engaging, and also noticed she was sucking on her food. Andrea tactfully asked why this was and discovered the resident's teeth were missing and her gums were very sore. She spoke honestly to the resident about the importance of getting a dental appointment and shared her own personal stories, which gave the resident the confidence to visit the dentist. Andrea also arranged for the resident to visit their mum, who was in a care home, and took a photo of them together to keep in their rooms as a keepsake. Andrea has an enormous heart and is dedicating to supporting others. She has the trust values at her core and is always striving to give a better, more meaningful experience to all of her residents.
And now over to Jazz to announce the winners.
Thanks, Patrick. So now the suspense is over. Shall we announce? Yeah, here we go then. So the Bronze Compassionate Award goes to... That wasn't very good. So the bronze one goes to Andrea. Andrea wasn't able to make it tonight, but we will make sure that award gets to her and take that personally. So without further ado, the silver award. Sorry, I'm not very good at this. Sorry, it's my first time. So the silver award goes to Nina. Ask me what I did with my life. I don't know if I'm expected to say anything, but I am. I'm going to take this moment. thank you so much for my nomination to my manager, Kat. You are amazing. And congratulations to everyone who's been nominated, and thank you so much, everyone. It means a lot. Thanks. Gold award goes to Zinnia. Put it up for
Thank you very much for this lovely gesture. I just want to say thank you to my beautiful wife for our support. I cannot underestimate the support I get from my team as well. Thank you to the Xenia team and the Nutcroft team. Thank you so much. Wow, that was beautiful, wasn't it? And we'll try and keep on track. The great first, we'll keep on track.